youngest, and at times littlest Americans celebrated Constitution Day and Citizenship Day by taking their oaths and taking a big step towards their American dreams.
It's more of opportunities. I think he has more, has a lot of things that he can offer here than back their country.
Yes, a lot of dreams. Like, at first he wants to go to the army, so you need to be a citizen, and then he wants to go to medical school again. He changed her mind, so you need to be a U.S. citizen when you want to go to a veterans hospital, or you can help with the U.S. government, anything.
It was a special occasion as these newly naturalized U.S. citizens got a warm multilingual welcome from L.A. Mayor Eric Garcetti.
I said salam because it's also, you know, I could say mabuhay. I got a lot of Tagalog for you, so don't worry.
While they're still too young to vote and won't be summoned for jury duty for a few more years, these new citizens are already eyeing some of the instant benefits.
I'm happy, Paul. Very happy. If I get my citizenship, I get my passport, and then I could travel and explore.
Over 80 youth representing nearly two dozen countries took their oath. Most of the children here are born of U.S. citizen parents abroad or are the children of naturalized Americans. For the U.S. Citizenship and Immigration Services, each child represents a family's journey.
It was an easy road for them, not so much necessarily for their parents, who left a lot of things behind to come to this country and form a new life here.
The week of September 27th to the 23rd is observed as Constitution Week, with the 17th known as Constitution Day and Citizenship Day, a time when the country remembers the signing of the U.S. Constitution and the Americans that continue to live by it, whether they are born in or out of the country. While some of them may be too young to realize it, a few years from now, these new Americans will be future voters, active participants, and possibly the voice of a new generation. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.